just to start. Okay, I'm John Atherton, that's me. Mark's very kindly said a few words about me. I'm going to talk about social intranets and extranets. Does everyone here know what an intranet is? Does anyone not know what an intranet is? Okay, two slides then, quickly covering social intranets and extranets. So, an intranet is all about a bunch of computers and a bunch of people, but that network is within the organisation, so it's all about, you know, we're not connected to the internet, so we've got a big conceptual brick wall in the way, and it might be a physical brick wall. Some organisations don't connect their intranets to the internet. Now, why would you not connect your intranet to the internet? Perhaps.
Privacy issues,
security, etc. What an extranet does is it takes that idea of a closed network a bit further and extends it out to maybe your customers, your partners, your suppliers. Maybe, so a little example here, the Ford Motor Company, they make cars, they get a lot of their components, their switches and the like from a big company called GKN, who supply the motor industry and avionics industry. Bristol Street Motors sell cars. You'd imagine that those three organisations are talking to each other. A lot of email going on. Perhaps they might decide to invest a bit of money in an infrastructure that allows them to collaborate more effectively. Okay, so that's an extranet, extending that idea out a little bit, but you've still got the brick wall between your extranet and the internet. Okay, in this case, it's probably a technology that's making a separation. Okay, so who uses WordPress here? Who blogs? Okay, so there's a number of ways to set up WordPress. You can go to wordpress.com, register, and you've got yourself a blog. You can go to an independent hosting company, such as UK2, pay them £3 a month, and they'll set up your own WordPress blogging platform. So that's yours. You own it. You can send the URL out, and friends or members of staff, whatever, can start blogging on that platform. It's sort of private. Or you can download WordPress, which is a free piece of software, open source, and you can stick it on your own server. Okay. Let's talk about that last example, because I'm going to talk about an intranet. We're going to keep it really simple. It's a physical air gap between you and the internet. So the only choice you have is option three. You've got to download WordPress, stick it on your network here, and hopefully your people can start blogging about the great things that they do within the company. Okay. So that's what I'm going to talk about. So you've got your social, your intranet, and you've stuck WordPress on it. Does that make it a social intranet? Well, I'd argue no, because I think that what makes a platform social is that it has to have these three key elements. The first is people. The second is relationships between those people. And finally, we've got activities that those people perform. And that's really key about a social platform, is that we use the relationships to filter the activities and the events that these people are performing. Does that make sense? So we're using that social graph, if you like, to filter the stuff that we care about and potentially amplify some of the things that we really care about, because we're probably following several people have similar interests, and the really good stuff is going to sort of bubble up to the top. So I would argue that WordPress on its own doesn't give you that relationship ability. Okay, it's got people and it's got activities, the activity being posting blogs, commenting on blogs, track backs, all that kind of stuff. So if you've got a social platform with these three key elements, we can do all these things, can't we? We can blog, we can bookmark things, we can write wiki pages, we can microblog tweets, etc., etc. And what the social network does for us is, as I say, it amplifies the stuff we care about and hopefully filters the stuff we don't, because we don't follow the people that, for whatever reason, we don't have an interest in. And those relationships on Facebook and on Twitter and on LinkedIn, for example, they're quite simple. You're a friend, or you're a follower, or a followee, or you're a connection. But they can be more complicated. They can be qualified. So you could just follow within an organisation, for example. You could just follow shop floor workers, etc., etc. So I'll talk about that later. Okay, so we looked at WordPress. If you added a little extension to WordPress called BuddyPress, which is also free, an open source piece of software, and you stuck those two things on your intranet, I would argue you've then got a social intranet, because that gives you your final element of the piece, that relationship piece. So you can't really see this, but up in that on those tabs, you can start befriending people and following activities of friends, that sort of thing. Here's another very quick example. This is a platform called Elle. Anyone heard of Elle? So another free open source platform. This is specifically a social networking platform, whereas WordPress is a blogging platform. So here we go. I've got loads of stuff going on, following my friends, and I can click on stuff I care about or decide to ignore it. Another very quick example. This is Telegen. This is a commercial product. I'll zoom in on this bit. We've got that activity thing going on again. And I'm following the people that I've made relationships with for whatever reason. Okay, at the 5 minute count, so I'll quickly whiz up. There are hundreds of platforms out there, commercial, open source, many, many more open source than commercial. The landscape for social media platforms out there is huge, as I'm sure you're all aware. So what I thought we could do is talk about what your social internet or intranet or extranet site might look like. Where's the return? Why would you do this? What's the benefit? Especially in the current climate, where's the payback? And I realise that some of you are freelance, so maybe I thought we could look at what the Prism social intranet site might look like. And of course, we've already got one. We've got, as Michael touched on earlier, we've got Prism.com, we've got the Facebook group, we've got the web paint site, we've got the blog, we've got Twitter as well. How do they all fit together? And what can we do to improve them? That's what I mean. Thank you very much.